Hi guys, in this video we will be explaining how to multiply two decimal values by converting to binary first and then multiply. We will also show you how to use the binary code system to see what is the values of the binary number before you do the calculation. So stay tuned for three examples. Let's have a look at the first one. The first one I'm going to have 44 multiplied by 3. So what I do first is I will take 44 and 3 and first put it into the code system like I have here. There we can see that the binary number 44 is 32 plus 8 plus 4 and the rest of the other values will be zeros. Same with 3. I'm going to use 2 and 1 and the rest will be zeros. The next thing that you will do is you will take 44 and multiply that by 3 to get what is your decimal number for those specific two values. Then you will take 132 and put it into the code system to see what is the binary equivalent for 132, which means that is actually going to be your actual answer when you multiply these two together. Right. This is a set of rules, which is basically the multiplication rules. There you can see anything multiplied by 0 will give me 0, and 1 times 0, or 1 times 1, will give me 1. Alright, so let's go ahead and do the actual calculation. There is my 44 in binary, and 3 in binary. So let's calculate and see what we get. 1 times 0 will give me 0, 1 times 0 will give me 0, 1 times 1 will give me 1, 1 times 1 will give me 1, 1 times 0 will give me 0, and 1 times 1 will give me 1 again. The next thing that you will do is you will have a placeholder here because we're going to start multiplying with the second digit and we need to start in my second column as well. So 1 times 0 will give me 0, 1 times 0, 0, 1 times 1, 1, 1 times 1, 1, 1 times 0, 0, and 1 times 1 will give me a 1. So now we need to add these two binary numbers together. 0 plus 0 will give me 0. The same here. 1 plus 0 will give me 1. 1 plus 1 will give me 0 with a carry of 1. 1 plus 1, 0 with a carry of 1. 1 plus 1, 0 with a carry of 1. And 1 plus 1 will give me 1, 0. So that is going to be my final answer for 44 multiplied by 3. The next thing that you need to do is you need to check if this value is the same as this value which I have in my code system. If those two values are correct, then you know you have correctly calculated 44 multiplied by 3. So let's go to my second example. In my second example, we're going to multiply 56 with 5. You can see in my first example, I had a binary number which had two digits only. In my second example, we're going to have the binary number 5, which has three digits. Right. So again, put it into your code system and see what is the actual value of 56 and 5 in binary. Then again, multiply 56 by 5, get your answer, and then take that answer, put it into the code system, and see what is the binary value for that, so you know what you need to get. Right. So let's go ahead and calculate. 1 times 0, 0, 1 times 0, 0, 1 times 0, 0, 1 times 1, 1, 1 times 1, 1, and 1 times 1 will give me a 1. Alright, again, placeholder, because I'm starting in the second column and I'm using my second digit. So here you can see we have all zeros because anything multiplied by a 0 will give me a 0. Next, I'm in my third column, and I'm going to have two placeholders there because I'm starting with my third digit. 1 times 0, 0, 1 times 0, 0, 1 times 0 will give me 0, and 1 times 1, 1, 1 times 1, 1, and 1 times 1 will give me a 1. Right. Next, and lastly, you need to add. That will be 0, that will be 0, that will be 0. 1 plus 0 is 1, 1 plus 0 is 1. 1 plus 1 will give me a 0 with a carry of 1. 1 plus 1, a 0 with a carry of 1. And 1 plus 1 is going to give me a 0 or and a 1, 1, 0. All right, so that is going to be my final answer for this multiplication calculation. All right, so then again, you can just check if your answer is correct. If it is correct, then you know you have done this calculation correctly. All right, let's go to my third and last example. In this example, we're going to have 28 multiplied by 9. What I want you to see here is that the number 9 has 4 digits in its binary number. So again, put that and that into the code system and see what is your binary value. Right. Again, multiply to see what is the actual value that you will get in decimal, and then put that into the code system to see what it is in binary, so that you know that that is the binary value that you need to get when you do the multiplication. Right, so let's go ahead and do this. 1 times 0 is 0, 1 times 0 is 0, 1 times 1, 1 times 1, and 1 times 1 will give me this 3 ones here. Right, again, next thing, placeholder, because I'm starting in my second column and I'm starting with my second digit. So anything multiplied by 0 will give me that zeros there. Next thing, I'm going to put two placeholders there because I'm starting with my third digit and I'm starting to calculate in my third column. Again, that will give me all zeros. Lastly, I'm going to put three placeholders there because I'm starting in my fourth column. There I am starting there. So 1 multiplied by 0 will give me 0. 1 multiplied by 0, 0. And 1 multiplied by 1 will give me 1. 1 multiplied by 1, 1. 1 times 1 will give me 1. As easy as that. Right. Lastly, you need to add that binary values which I have there. There I will have 0. There I will have 0. 1 plus 0 will give me 1. 1 plus 0, 1. 1 plus 0, 1. 0 plus 1, 1, 0 plus 1, 1, and 1 plus a 0, that's actually 0 there, will give me 1, and that is your final answer for this specific calculation. Now you can check your answer, there I got that, see if it's exactly the same as this one. If it is, then you know you have done your calculation correctly. Thanks for watching.